Sorry about that, everybody. I filmed about 20 minutes of an ad lib video for you guys, and then after my 20 minute ad lib video, found out that my husband had done something with the sound, and I wasn't able to pick up audio. So rather than do a even more awkward video, this time I'm just going to change it up a little bit from how I was initially going to do it, and still wanted to share my exciting news with you guys about being copyrighted. So thank you for staying tuned and being patient, and I really appreciate that. So here we go. Earlier this spring, after drawing the characters for almost a couple of years, I finally applied for copyright and was very excited a couple weeks ago when Rob brought home the mail. And he was coming in from work, and he handed me this large sort of 8x10 envelope, and it was addressed to me from the federal government, so I figured, well, since it's not tax season, this can only mean one thing. Literally, the first thing I did when I opened it and realized what it was I jumped around our living room. Then a couple of weeks later, Rob and I hosted a wine and cheese party, a little get-together, and oh my goodness, we had everyone from amazing neighbors in our building to some of my in-laws, and some of Rob and mine's mixed friends, and even people from the arts community. So we had quite mixed company, and that was just amazing. I mean, that was an incredible evening. I loved every minute of it. So, what are the zooed animal hybrid friends? Great question. Dogasaur is a cross between a golden retriever and a stegosaurus, and his personality is kind of impulsive, a little bit goofy. He can have little temper tantrums, but overall he's friendly. He's very playful. And Pandaroo is a cross, obviously, between a panda bear and a kangaroo, and he's kind of the personality opposite of Dogasaur, because Pandaroo is a little more morose, a deep thinker, not super energetic, and he's just overall more realistic, a little bit pessimistic. And then Parafly, oh my goodness, he's as colorful in personality as he is in body. So he is a cross between an African gray parrot and a butterfly, and he was very fun to draw, fun to design, and he's got like a dad joke sort of persona, very goofy, but he can be serious if he needs to be. And then Slowon, I kind of identify with him a little bit. He likes to sleep. He's very chill, very laid back, relaxed, kind of a hippie, almost a surfer dude. So he's a cross between a swan and a sloth, and obviously his sloth side is his dominant side. And then Elefox, well, he's big like Dogasaur, but I consider Elefox to be a gentle giant. Ultimately, he just loves to eat. He loves chocolate ice cream. He's usually munching on something. And, you know, he's just like a big cuddle bug, and he's everybody's friend. And then Beaver, well, he's probably the most punny of all. If you look at his body, you can see that he literally has an actual beaver tail, and the rest of him is just a very friendly bee. And he doesn't sting. He's super friendly. He's very hardworking. He loves flowers. He loves to decorate with flowers. He's kind of feminine, but, you know, that's totally okay. And then Rabird. I identify with Rabird the most because, like me, she's shy and socially anxious, but she's also very creative and a very deep feeler. So she loves to write haikus. She's got her own little poetry book. And she is a cross between an Angora rabbit and a dove. So that's why she's just so fluffy and so cute. And then Frugal, like Beaver, she's kind of punny. She is a cross between a pond frog and a poodle. So as you can see, she's very fluffy. She looks almost like she's got wool, like a sheep. And I enjoy drawing her hair first and then putting her frog features in afterward. And then Unicat, she is kind of my alter ego. She is best friends with Rabbit, and they are truly opposite. Unicat is the, hey, look at me, kind of character. She's part unicorn and obviously part cat. I think of her as a Persian cat, so I think she's fluffy and petable. And then Pinguana, he's kind of got an inner conflict. If you look at his back half, he's an iguana, so that half loves the heat, loves the sun. And then his front half is a penguin who loves Arctic cold. So that's kind of, it was fun putting two very different aspects into one character like that. And like Unicat, Zebat, part zebra and part bat, is one of my favorites to voice because she's got the French accent, ooh la la. She's very romantic, very feminine, playful and fun, free-spirited. And if you look at her chest, I drew a little heart-shaped patch there just to emphasize her femininity. She's also the only character with green eyes, which I really enjoy drawing because I have green eyes as well. And then last but not least is the adorable baby Octomouse. She's the youngest of them all. I didn't give them specific ages, but she is definitely youthful. She is part field mouse and part octopus, and she's got these cute little stubby tentacles so she can swim. And I want to add that they live on a planet called Zerpod, which is an acronym of some of their names. So, what now? Glad you asked. So after the initial celebration had come and gone, the next thing on my agenda was to convert our den into a home office for me to do things such as a webcomic, and I'm looking to do children's books, and I want to do a specific book by Rabbit that is a book of her haiku poetry. So I'm looking forward to doing things such as that, and I'll let you know what else comes from this. Okay, let's talk quickly about Patreon. What is it? Patreon is a fundraising platform for artists and entertainers. Some of you are already pledging to support me, well, to support us, the animals, and I really appreciate that. Thank you. For the rest of you, I'll explain the three tiers. The dollar a month tier includes a monthly coloring page, plus a 40% discount code in my Etsy shop, and access to exclusive posts, so posts that only paid pledgers will see. And the $5 a month tier includes all of that, plus commissioned caricature work in any style you choose. So if you want me to draw a picture of you or a loved one of yours, I will do that for you once a month in any cartoon style that you ask me to do. And then the new $30 tier includes all of that previously mentioned, plus now you can get a t-shirt or tote bag with Zood characters right on them. So those will come from my Redbubble shop, and I will order them for you as per your request. And you can pledge once or twice if you want and then stop, especially with the higher tiers. But I still really appreciate the support. It means a lot. It helps with being able to afford things like the recent coffee rate, because that was $50, and being able to pay the Red Deer Arts Council member fee, which is $30 a year, as well as save toward a proper website domain, and even buy items from my own Redbubble shop for advertising purposes, which is really helpful. It gets a lot of eyes on these characters and is an excuse to talk to strangers, and that's just absolutely awesome. So you're really helping me a lot when you pledge. And for the next while, New patrons will get an exclusive sticker designed by me to say thank you. Thank you so much if you sat through this entire video. I did have other plans for it, and I really appreciate your patience sitting with me while I reworked it. So thank you so much for being here and supporting me along this journey and supporting the Zoot Animal Hybrid Friends. You will definitely be rewarded.